Okay, welcome to a class on colons and semicolons. I think people often believe that these two are much more complicated than commas, and I'm glad to say it's not true. Commas are the complicated one. Commas are far more complex because they are used for far more, a greater range of reasons, yeah, a lot more different reasons than colons and semicolons. I'm just going to give you two tips for colons and two tips for semicolons. So I've tried to make this straightforward. So the first reason that you use a colon is to give a list or an explanation. And when you do this, the colon normally means the word namely. And what you usually see most of the time is main clause, or you ought to, you don't always actually, and this is considered a mistake in academic English, but you see main clause and then a colon, which means namely, and then a list or an explanation. So what do I mean? Here's an example. The second one is the example. You see, we have decided to buy the following, and that must be there. Namely, eggs, cheese, that's an Oxford comma, guys, and milk. So this is the correct one, although you might get rid of the Oxford comma if you're not a fan of the Oxford comma. And I must admit, this is a really simple list, and so you don't need the Oxford comma to stop any confusion. But I tend to put it in, and it's just because I think it's less confusing to use the Oxford comma, personally. But I want to make it clear that this is wrong. You see it very often. You see something like this. We have decided to buy, namely, eggs, cheese and milk. Well, that's not okay. That's not okay at all. Why? Because it's unnecessary. Yeah, look at that. We have decided to buy egg, cheese and milk. That's correct. Yeah, if you get rid of the colon, it's correct. Yeah, because that's one main clause. And so do be aware that when you're using a colon, you ought to have in academic English. Yeah, this is something that academic study guides recommend, and they want to see. They want to see the main clause before the colon, and not that, because that doesn't warrant a colon. That just warrants one sentence, yeah? We have decided to buy eggs, cheese and milk. So I hope that's clear, and I hope you can see how you can use the word namely, yeah? We have decided to buy the following, namely, eggs, cheese and milk. That will help you understand the colon a little bit better. And if you're any young students out there, I think that's a nice, easy, clear way of understanding what the colon is used for. Yeah, but it doesn't have to be a list. It might be an explanation. So here's an example from 1984. There is a word in newspeak, said Simmy. Do pay attention to the commas for the direct speech, yeah? Inside the speech marks and then outside the speech marks. I don't know whether you know it, yeah? Namely, duck speak, to quack like a duck. So duck speak is the word in newspeak that Simmy is talking about. And you can see how it's, oh, I don't know whether you know it, namely, duck speak, to quack like a duck. Now, this here is an explanation of what the word is, which he's not sure whether Winston knows. It's an explanation, so here, you can see it's not always a list. It could be an explanation as well that comes after the colon. OK, now a second thing to remember, which you might argue is what's going on here, is that important direct speech. Yeah. Now, what do I mean important? Well, important direct speech is often use a colon instead of just speech marks. And so we'll have a look at this firstly from. Yeah, from 1984, perhaps one of the most important bits from 1984. But I did want to point out, just before we look at that sentence, let me find it. Yeah, you do notice that colons are used in Animal Farm for the songs and for the Seven Commandments. You see a colon. So you can see that it's an important part of the story, the songs, the Seven Commandments, and also you can see that this isn't actually direct speech, but it's what's written on the Seven Commandments tablet, yeah? Or it's the song, and so it's not what's just spoken, it's what's sung. And so I think we very often see colon for when it's not direct speech, but when it's a song or when it's a really important Seven Commandments. So is it the Seven Commandments? I think it is, yeah, the Seven Commandments. So it's a really important part of the story. In 1984, you see the colon being used to introduce the notes from Winston's diary. Okay, so Winston's diary is a very important part of the story, and you see the colon being used to introduce it. In Frankenstein, the colon introduces the letters and poems that are quoted. Yeah, so you can see that we very often use this colon for the important parts of the story.